Introducing to you first, fighting in the red corner from Nosny Academy. We have together for Samir Bouamrane. Fighting out of the blue corner from Tsunami Cambridge, we have together for Sam Cottam.
Samir Bouamrane from the Nolsey Academy, wearing the black shorts with the fluorescent ankle sleeve, and then in the blue corner, Sam Cottam with the all-white shorts, fighting out Tsunami Cambridge. This is for the 74-kilo WKA Southern Area Pro K1 title, and I'm really looking forward to this, Dean. Bouamrane won the 70kg K1 title on Raw, beating Ben Wallace, who we saw win in devastating fashion last time out on Contenders. But here he's stepping up 4 kilos to fight a guy, Sam Cottam, who's fought much higher than 74 kilos. He fought 76 kilos last time out. So let's see if size is going to be a key as we get underway here in round 1, Dean.
Yeah, watch out for the axe kicks there from Samir. An awesome axe kick, particularly when his opponent is backing up. I mean, but Cottam has got some beautiful Muay Thai skills and uses that left hand with the jab and the hook there, as we see, to gauge distance, set up that right hand.
See straight away, Cottam fighting like he is the bigger, stronger man, walking Bouamrane down. As you say, Bouamrane's got some wonderful, got some wonderful kick techniques. Loves the axe kick, loves the teep to the face. Let's see if he can bring some of those out. At the moment, Cottam just walking him to the ropes.
Cottam very athletic and powerful. Eats a teep to the face, however, not of approval. He does a great job of catching kicks as well, does Cottam. So watch out for that. He'll catch the kick and he'll counter immediately.
That was a nice kick there from Cottam as well. Looking at low kick with his knee, and that hurts. They're right in front of us here. Let's hope we're not a repeat of what we just saw.
For the big kick there, the body just misses its mark. Cottam now taking centre ring. He's done a great job, really dictating the pace here. But Ronnie's got to start switching up these strikes. He's got to start pressuring forward.
Yeah, you can see Cottam, as I say, he's a man who's fought at a higher weight. And he's just marching forward at the moment, putting on Bouamrane. Very classical Thai style so far from Cottam. Nice body head mix from Bouamrane. Throws the low kick as well as he looks to an impression to fight. There's an axe kick you alluded to, Dean. He will throw these.
He's got a beautiful spinning back fist as well. So I'd like to see him do that, because it kind of switch up the trajectory of this fight and not allow Cottam to kind of set in front, gauge the distance. Oh, hey, it's a beautiful axe kick again. But you can see that Cottam's coming forward. He's using that lead hand to parry out. They're firing power kicks and punches.
Yeah, as I say, Cottam's definitely fighting like the bigger, stronger man. He's looking just to walk down Bouamrane, and he's backed him up most of the time in the first round to the ropes. First, as I say, 5 3-minute rounds here for the title, the Southern Area K1 title, WKO. Yes.
Ronnie's corner, calling him out to move. They don't want his back against those ropes there, man.
Nice left hook there from Bouamrane as Cottam looks to come in. Doing some good work now, Bouamrane. Holding head, mixing up nicely.
It's interesting to watch this, because traditionally Cottam kind of is a slow starter. He'll feel out, not much like a Muay Thai specialist, feel out the earlier rounds and then really come with a barrage of punches and full power in the later rounds. But we're seeing pressure forward a little bit here. Could suggest here that Bouamrane needs to switch it up. Nice kick down inside the leg. We need to start thinking about setting these high kicks up. Oh, yeah, there's a spinning back fist.
As you said, Dean, the great read, he does throw those a lot, and they do land quite a lot as well, so Cottam has got to be aware of that. Fascinating first round there, Dean. Very well paced. Interesting matchup between Cottam, who looks like a very traditional Thai stylist, and Bouamrane, who will throw all sorts of flashy techniques effectively. You see a lot of guys throw these flashy techniques and don't land, but he does land them.
Yeah, it kind of just disrupts the trajectory of your motion and your combinations. Can you imagine if you're going to throw a 1-2 left hook finish with a lovely head kick? If a spinning back fist comes flying out at you, and if it connects, it can drop you, so you have to be very careful. And Bouamrane does a great job of being unorthodox, and he can't really plan for that, because he throws the crazy axe kicks, the spinning back fist. He needs to start digging into the toolbox now in this second round and throwing combinations with unorthodox strikes to try and catch Cottam out.
I think what will also be key as we get deeper into the fight, as I say, 5 3-minute rounds. Bouamrane is much the smaller man, to say. 70 kilo K1 champion, he's 4 kilos high, that's 1 stone. Against Cottam, who is, you can see in the ring, he looks like he's a different weight division, doesn't he? He's a much bigger guy. So see, as we get deeper into the fight, how Bouamrane's cardio will hold up in there against the bigger, stronger man. He's certainly had success in that first round. As we get ready for round two here. Round two, underway, Dean.
Bouamrane's got a nice Superman punch as well. There's the kicks, that's what I'm talking about. He's got to switch the kicks up, go to the head, keep very active, and actually pressure Cottam back to beat him at his own game, so to speak.
It's fun to watch, isn't he, Bouamrane? He's got all the tricks. The circus. Nice work there from Cottam, traditional, as I say, Thai techniques, catching the kick and making the man go to the floor.
With the high guard, spinning back fist there.
Bouamrane backing Cottam up for the first time there. Nice low kick from Cottam.
Bouamrane's got to come forward, he's got to circle out of this position here. Use the left hooks to keep his hands up.
Nice spear knee on the ropes there, another Thai technique from Cottam. Bouamrane comes back with those powerful hooks, goes up top with a head kick.
This is the key here for Bouamrane. Finish off those combination with leg kicks here.
You can see actually as Bouamrane circles in front of us, his leg is actually red and bleeding from the leg kick.
Might be a cut there from Cottam's right leg. like maybe split his shin there on the lower part of his leg. Difficult to see from this position.
Look at the weight as well on the inside of Bouamrane's lead leg. His leg kicks are chopping him down.
And the right hands there. And again, missed the kick and comes straight back with a side kick to the belly.
And this is back and forth action right here. Contenders Kickboxing. First time of the night. Nice shots there from Bouamrane. He may have troubled Cottam for the first time.
Bouamrane much more active now. It looks like a completely different fighter here in the later rounds. He's using the movement beautifully. He's switching up the techniques. He's finishing with the kicks, switching stances.
And he's backing Cottam up now as well, which we didn't see at all in the first round. Cottam was just marching him down. But Cottam is going backwards at some points in this round. He's landing some big shots. Goes for the question mark kick. Oh, yeah, big right hand there. Rock Cottam.
Only again backing up. Working high guard, looking to respond immediately with a left and right hand combination. Body head, beautiful work here from Bouamrane.
Really sunk in that hook and then went to the head. Another chopping low kick as Cottam backs up.
Bouamrane setting up that low kick there and he went up to the head there with that teep. So he faked the low, went high into the face there. This is what he needs, is to switch up the techniques, use fakes and feints. Work the head kicks and constantly keep Cottam on the back foot.
Oi, and there's that big spinning back fist again, which he likes. He loves that technique. He's certainly backing Cottam up a lot more in that second round, Dean. And if the first round went the way of Cottam, you'd have to say that round went the way of Bouamrane, backing Cottam up and using some really nice techniques to score heavily.
You can immediately see, as soon as Bouamrane lets off, Cottam comes forward, and it forces Bouamrane to keep his hands up. And you can see the confidence growing Cottam, and he's going to look to see what he can land. But Bouamrane doing a great job pressuring back.
Hold on, what's
here.
Going on here? Looks like the fight may be over. Bouamrane celebrating.
Look, contributing to that cut. You see, it's bleeding quite profusely.
Injury to his right leg here, just in front of it. It's bleeding heavily. Doctor's checking his eyes, but I think it must be the cut there that's injury to the right leg.
That was shaping up to be an absolute war. I mean, that could have been a clash of shins there, check from Bouamrane, but either way, Bouamrane did a great job pressuring back Cottam.
Certainly looks to me, Cottam in some distress in the corner. Not quite sure, as I say, he's definitely cut to the leg, but he's also, the doctor's looking into his eyes and sort of talking to him. Clear, really, what injury stopped that fight, but what we know is Bouamrane celebrating, and we have the 74 kilos, WKO, sudden area title in the ring.
Well, ladies and gents, let's hear it for both these fighters in the ring, please. For a couple of pros right there. But ladies and gentlemen, after two hard-fought rounds, Sam Cottam is deemed unable to continue. So ladies and gentlemen, your new WKO Southern Area Pro K1 champion, let's hear it for Samir Bouamrane! And to present the belt, we have Amy from HS Lubricants. Ladies and gents, let's hear it for Sam Cottam!